Elizabeth, and like I told you, in each and every class, as we have inclusion, even in these classes, we have children who have challenges. Like we have James, who has also Down syndrome. He's here, although the teacher again has to create some time for him. Akinyi, say hello. She came here, she didn't have speech, she came with older than the others, as you can see she's older. But right now her cognitive value is like the one with PP1 and PP2. So we decided let her grow with them, doing what they are supposed to do. Usually there are some others also who came from, can find some, they don't even have a uniform, we are trusting God to get them uniform. There are some we get them, even the teacher gets wonders how she can get their names, even yesterday, because since they came here, we've never had seen somebody who says it's a parent. We don't know their names, we don't know what they are called. Sometimes they give us this name the other day, but all we are doing is we are not ready to let any child out there. We are here to change their lives, and they are acceptable. So the greatest challenge that we have also in this class is some of them, we get them, they come, trace their sense of belonging becomes a problem. But all we are working to is to make sure that each and every child under the sun get a sense of belonging. Even if it's like a home that we start a home whereby they will be monitored physically, spiritually, education-wise, and all the aspects of their lives. They are being monitored. At the end of it, when they go out there, they will become acceptable members in the society. This is usually the class that has children who have multiple disabilities. We find that most of them have motor problems, cognitive problems, and even motor, I mean fine and gross motor. Most of them are in wheelchairs, they don't have speech. So we start with them here. But all I'm happy is that each and every day we are able to see children with smiling faces. They are attaining skills slowly by slowly. So you are most welcome out there, wherever you are. It's good that you feel part and parcel of us, because we are here to make a difference. All we know and we believe is every child has potential, all they need to be is to be accepted in the society. The right placement is done, and at the end of it, that they will be independent and fruitful members in the society. This is the playgroup class with Teacher Jacqueline. She's the one who handles this tender, her children. Like initially I told you, we are creating a society whereby everyone out there should know that even if a child has a challenge, it doesn't limit him or her to be inclusive in learning. And that is why this is just a tender class from age 3. Sama, hello. He's called Emmanuel. He has a condition by name hydrocephalus, but he's still fit. Although the teacher has to have IEP, individual education plan, for him, because he might be delayed a little, but he's fit in the class. The other children, no. He might not speak like they're speaking, but still, the other children, we are creating a society, they have to accept it. He might not be fluent, he might not be as cognitively sound like they are, but they feel Emmanuel is part and parcel of a humanitarian playgroup class. And I want also to thank the teacher so much, because she has created room, she has knowledge, and she has accommodated them. We also have Mercy. Mercy has a condition, Down syndrome, but still she's accommodated here. You see now she's the children learn more from what they see others do. Right now they are able to sit. Yes, she has some special needs, but she's learning from the others. She can sit, she can concentrate with whatever they are doing, and she's learning. So when they go out there in future, even if the neighbors or whoever is around her, she has gotten used to the routine. She knows it's time to sit in class, it's time to do the plaster scene, it's time to scribble. She might be coloring number 1, and when the next neighbor is really even writing number 10. But all in all, they are doing cognitive, and each and every child is acceptable. Doesn't matter the level they are, but we are doing the best. Yeah, we are doing the best to assess and explore every talent in a child. This is our sensory room. We do therapy here, and even children come usually who have sensory integration. Some of them, after the massage, they relax here, because those who have the visual problems, they can look up. Those are very stimulating things. We are still making the room so that when they come here, they just relax and feel good. As you can see, we have different reflecting objects up there. There are children who want something that glitters so that they can attract their eyes and whatever they need. Yeah. there, locally, internationally, is Welcome to Humanitarian Education Center, where by the fear of God is wisdom and everyone is somebody. We are located in Kawangware, 46 Terminus, U-turn right. The landmarks are Full Gospel Church, then we are inside the church, Free Pentecost Church. Next to come and right adjacent to Muslim Primary School, you are most welcome. Be part and parcel of us, because we know one day, one time, you will give an account of whatever you've given to the society. And again, it doesn't matter who you are, we all have challenges, it's only that our degree varies. Remember, we are all drops of our ocean, we are all waves on one sea. Come and join us as we make these little angels their lives better than we met it.